they land there, some people say, and the people who went there, they say that they actually landed there. It's not a question of whether landing, you know. These are controversies.
There has been some dispute.
These are controversies. We do not go into these controversies. We go for pure science. What I am saying, what I have done is that, you know, how the universe has been created, how the cosmos has been created, what was the process of creation, what were the laws applied for this creation, the intelligent design, that God has created in such a way, He must have applied certain laws. So those laws I have found out. Those laws are very simple, like Einstein's E is equal to mc square. My first formula which I found out is E is equal to r square. It's such a small formula. God has done, God has created everything in a very simplistic way so that simple people can understand. He has not gone for any complicated thing, I promise you. He has not done so. I assure you, He has not done so. So that every simple individual can understand it. God loves a scientist and He doesn't love a common man. It's not that. He loves everybody. So He has created everything with formulae which are very simple and which are understandable by a scientist as well as a commoner. So I have done that. I have found out those formulae. I have found out how cosmos has been created. Now, while doing that, you know, I have agreed with the Big Bang Theory. The Big Bang Theory, it is said that from a very small, very, very small, tiny particle, you know, the entire cosmos has been created. You know that? Yeah. Infinitesimally small particles, the entire cosmos has been created. Yeah, you can't even see. So it is true. So their finding is true. And this has been supported in the Bhagavatam also. Okay. Bhagavatam states that it started from a zero state. That means nothing was there. Then something was created. Okay. A small particle was created and from that the entire cosmos was created. Now, the second thing which I have accepted is are the laws of planetary science. The present planetary science, the laws I have accepted. So I have worked on those only. I have not done something, you know, from the moon or from the air. Based on the planetary science prevailing now, I have worked on. Based on the present science, present-day physics, present-day astrophysics, I have worked on, I have just extended it and found out those laws. So I believe in the Big Bang Theory, I believe in the present astrophysics, planetary science. The scientists have done marvelous job no doubt, but they have not extended it to that extent where I have found it.
So how does this merge into the theory that the universe was created from the thoughts of Mahavishnu? Being there, how does this relate to each other, connect to each other?
I'm sorry to state that, you know, beyond that creation, I do not know much. I only know that there was a small, infinitesimally small particle, and from that, you know, everything has been created. And that's absolutely true. I do not know beyond that, where the heaven is, where Lord Vishnu is. I don't know, because that I have not seen in my calculations. I have done my work as a scientist, and I have seen similarities between my findings and the narrations of the Bhagavad Gita. But beyond that, you know, where Lord Vishnu is there, what were his thoughts, those I don't know. Those are stated. Possibly I have to worship Lord Vishnu more and more to understand that. That's a state of realization. I'll have to attain. Okay. Now I have worked as a scientist. To realize something, I'll have to worship. I'll have to meditate. I'll have to pray, otherwise I won't know. Because till now I have not seen God. I have done as a scientist. And my findings have conformities with the narrations of Srimad Bhagavatam, which I have stated to you. And I am assuring you again that Srimad Bhagavatam is true. There are some narrations, some stories, you know, which you may not agree because you do not know those. But the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam is so true. I loved it.
Srimad Bhagavatam does confirm the Big Bang theory.
Of course.
And this also, our Dhanri Maharaj has done a lot of research into this also. What is in his book on cosmology and that. And he has written several books. So is this in line with that also of your research?
I have not read this book so far, but I have seen the Vedic cosmology done by some people of this book. I have seen that. Possibly Sri Dhanavir Goswami's writers are also included in those. I have seen those. In those, you know, according to what Srimad Bhagavatam has said, they have tried to locate the stars, different stars, you know. But what I have done as a scientist, I have found out the equations, the formula, the law, you know. Scientists are supposed to find out the law through which God has created this. Like say, simple thing, Newton's law is P is equal to mf, okay. Has Newton created it? Newton discovered it. So it is not Newton's law. God's law, which Newton has discovered. Einstein is equal to mc square is not Einstein's law. Is it Einstein's law?
No.
It is God's law. Einstein has discovered. We wrongly say that it is Einstein's law. So these laws are all created by God. We are trying to discover them. So I have discovered the laws of creation, how he has created, the cosmos. And through these, you know, by these equations, you can locate the stars, you know, now, at present, in future, or in the past. You can locate by virtue of these equations. So these are based on equations, by mathematical calculations. And these equations are valid today, yesterday, tomorrow also. Because these are basic equations through which God has created it.
Connect your research and what you are saying to the Hare Krishna movement of the devotion.
I couldn't follow you. Please repeat again.
Can you connect this, your finding and this science, okay, to Hare Krishna movement of love and devotion and service? Can you connect science into the devotional activity?
No, I have certain realizations in these. I was discussing with some of the devotees today. After I found it out, for last 2 years I went through all the religious books, the Holy Bible, the Holy Quran, and also all the religious books of Sanatana Dharma, like Bhagavad Gita. So, what I have realized is that there are three ways of getting in touch with the Supreme Soul, that is, God. If you want to be in touch with God, there are three ways. After going through all these books, and I found out, these three ways are karma, jnana, and bhakti. So, if you do good deeds, then you can get Lord Krishna. You can reach up to Him. If you do good deeds means when you do good deeds, you do not have any greed, you do not have any anger, you do not have any perversion, you do not have any jealousy, you do not have any false ego. So if these things are not there, then this is called a good karma. That, with that also, I mean, if you work in your office, come back to your house, eat, enjoy, but if you are very perfect about these seven things, काम क्रोध मोह लोभ मद वात्सल्य अहम फॉल्स ईगो. इफ यू आर डिवाइड ऑफ ऑल दीज थिंग्स देन स्टिल यू कैन रीच गॉड. दिस इज माय रियलिटी. द सेकेंड वे इज ज्ञान. ज्ञान मीन्स योर सोल नोज एवरीथिंग बट योर सोल इज सराउंडेड बाय वाइसेस. दैट्स व्हाई यू डोंट रियलाइज. If your soul expresses and teaches you, tells you the entire knowledge of the universe, the cosmos, why we are coming, why we are going, dying, you know, what is the reason? All these things, if you know, that is called jnana. Through jnana also you can reach Lord Krishna. And the third, the easiest way in Kali Yuga is you should have apara bhakti. You should have complete devotion to Lord Krishna. If you have complete devotion to Lord Krishna, then you can reach Him. If you have devotion, then actually you will be doing good karma. If you are doing good karma, you will definitely learn, if you will have good jnana also. See, from today, you decide to say Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. You go on saying this for months, years together. I am telling you, after 3 years, you will not be able to tell any lie to anybody. You will not be able to steal anybody's wealth. You will not be able to have a hanker after something. You will forget about the material attachment. So basically, through chanting, you know, through bhakti, you are achieving good karma. Okay, so you are working in your office, but you have bhakti within you, your karma will be good karma. You will reach Lord Krishna. This is my, after reading books, you know, this is my realization. Do you agree with this?
You say read the books. I mean, after doing this devotion, bhakti, that's what your realization is, rather than the books, right?
No, after reading these books, no. While I was doing this, you know, I had some realization. But after going through the books, I find this. In all these books, religious books, this has been stated. That you should not, this kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, vatsalya, aham, these things should not be there in anybody. A man should be disciplined, perfect.